वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स फॉर दिस क्लास. इन लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी डिस्कस द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डेरिवेशन दैट इज एंगल बिटवीन रेडियस वेक्टर एंड टेंजेंट. सो दैट वॉज अ वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट डेरिवेशन फॉर योर एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. ओके सो नाउ विल डिस्कस द अंदर डेरिवेशन. दिस डेरिवेशन दे हैव आस्क नॉट रेगुलरली, दे हैव आस्क टू टू थ्री टाइम्स. Okay, so this derivation name is length of the perpendicular from the pole to the tangent. Okay, so length of the perpendicular from the pole to the tangent. Okay, so there is an important derivation. This is also, so they used to ask in the examination with usual notation, prove that this expression. So prove that this expression 1 divided by p square is equal to 1 divided by r square plus 1 by r raised to 4. Into bracket dr upon d theta the whole square. They used to ask to prove this one. Okay, so this is your important derivation. So how to start this derivation I used to tell you. So first you start with by taking, let O be the pole. You take a one point here, O be the pole, so be the pole, and OL be the initial line. Draw this OL and it is called as a initial line. Then you take a one curve, okay, you take one curve. This curve is defined as r is equal to f of theta. As we have taken in the previous derivation, the polar curve should be taken. So therefore, r is equal to f of theta be the curve. On this curve, you take one point here, that is the point that is p of r theta. Be any point on the curve, okay, and hence this OP, you know that it is denoted by radius vector, and this angle is denoted by vectorial angle. Okay, that I have written here. Then draw ON. So you draw ON which is perpendicular to this tangent. You draw one tangent here. So tangent which is touches to the curve, this is known as a tangent. Draw the tangent and draw ON perpendicular this NP. Okay, so draw ON to the length of the tangent at P. Okay, let phi, this angle is denoted by phi, be the angle between this radius vector and tangent. You know this one, we have derived this one, that is length of the angle between radius vector and tangent. We usually denote it as phi, which I have taken in previous derivation also, same phi. Okay, with phi be the angle made by the radius vector with the tangent. And from this totally figure, that is angle ONP. You see here, angle ONP. Now your aim is that length of the perpendicular from the pole to the tangent. That is the length of the perpendicular. This is the perpendicular line from the pole to the tangent. So you need to find this ON. Okay, you need to find this ON. They told us to find the length of the perpendicular, from the pole to the tangent. Okay, so this you have to find. So in the figure, that is ONP is 90 degree and angle LOP is theta. That is LOP is theta. Okay, from the right angle triangle, they have defined angle phi. Okay, they have defined angle phi, that is sine theta or sine phi. Sine phi is opposite divided by, this is now hypotenuse, right? Opposite, ON divided by OP. So ON divided by OP. So therefore ON is R and OP, ON is, you defined with this one as a P, you defined this one as a small p. So you can write here, that is ON, you can write, and ON is equal to, that is a small p, you defined here, ON is equal to p. So therefore r divided by p, sorry, p divided by r, opposite, p divided by r. So p divided by r, leave this one, cross multiply this r here, so it becomes r sin phi. R sin phi is equal to p, call it as equation 1. Okay, now we know that from the previous derivations. So in the previous derivation, we have proved, that is, we have proved this derivation, that is tan phi is equal to r into d theta upon
d theta upon dr. We have proved this one, and we have gone further that, so I have taken a reciprocal. The reciprocal of tan is cot phi. You have to take the reciprocal, the 1 by r dr upon d theta. So we know this expression from the previous derivation. Use this previous derivation expression. You go through the notes, you get to know. So I have proved this one also. So therefore we know that. So already we know this one, that is cot phi is equal to 1 by r dr upon d theta. Call it as equation 2. Okay. After this equation 192, let us move further. That is what I have did is that squaring 1 and equation 1 and taking reciprocals here. Squaring equation 1 and taking reciprocal. So squaring equation 1 means p square r square sine square phi. Okay, this is squaring. And taking reciprocal means 1 by p square, 1 by r square, 1 by sine square phi. So I have written reciprocal. Then 1 by p square, 1 by r square as it is. 1 by sine is nothing but cosec square by the trigonometric. Okay, so 1 by p square is equal to 1 by r square. Cosec square is nothing but, that is identity, 1 plus cot square phi. You know this expression. Okay, this is the standard which already studied in your formulas. That's why I have given a list of formulas for these all trigonometric formulas. Is it clear? Now 1 by p square is equal to 1 by r square as it is, this one as it is, plus cot phi. You know that cot phi is denoted by, cot phi is denoted by 1 by r dr upon theta. But here it is square, so therefore it becomes 1 by r square dr upon d theta the whole square. So I have written like this. Squaring this term. That means you have to square this one and you have to put here. So then later on multiply 1 by r square inside. So 1 by r square into 1 za 1 by r square. 1 by r square into 1 by r square is 1 by r raised to 4 dr upon d theta the whole square. So this is a required derivation, that is the length of the perpendicular from the length of the perpendicular from the pole to the tangent. So this is a required derivation. But further there is a small derivation. If you, they ask like this, 1 by p square is equal to u square plus dou u, du upon d theta whole square. You have to go further. That means you have to take 1 by r is equal to u. If you are taking a substitution, you have to differentiate. So differentiation of 1 by r with respect to theta, that is differentiate with respect to theta this one, with respect to theta this one. So differentiation of 1 by r, you know that. Differentiation of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. Is it clear? Similarly, here also differentiation of 1 by r is minus 1 by r square. Differentiation of r with respect to theta is dr upon d theta. Is equal to differentiation of u with respect to theta is du upon d theta. Now further, I used to go like this, squaring on both sides. U square on both sides, squaring means plus becomes, here it becomes raised to 4, dou dr upon d theta the whole square is equal to u square this one, this one. Okay, now put in 3, use this expression in 3. See, see here, 1 by p square as it is, 1 by r, you know that. So this is a square. 1 by r is nothing but u. 1 by r square is nothing but what? U square. So u square plus here 1 by r raised to 4, say dr upon d theta whole square, same is there. Instead of this term, you can substitute this. This I can write here. So it become like this here. So du upon d theta the square. So which is a required derivation here. Okay. So this is the proof. So you go through this proof. Write it 2 to 3 times by seeing, then close the book and start to solve this or derive this derivation without seeing. Very important derivations are there. So this expression we are using in the further examples. This expression, that is length of the perpendicular from the pole to the tangent, that expression is given as 1 by p square is equal to 1 by r square plus 1 by r raised to 4 dr upon d theta the whole square. This expression, even what we have proved in the previous, that is derivation, first derivation, this expression is very, very important for further solving the examples. Okay, I hope you have understand this one. Then after this, I'm going to start with the examples of this angle between the two polar curves there. Okay, that I will discuss in a next video lecture. Thank you.